Statement and questions.
Proud of the boys tonight. It wasn't our best first period. I thought we struggled a little bit. I give a lot of credit to Dartmouth. I thought they played a great role first period and kind of came after us a little bit. We were really good. Not so much the first shift, the second, but really probably about the 16, 17 minute mark of the second. It was excellent. Battling, winning races, and doing a good job, and finding a way to win a hockey game. So I'm proud of the boys.
Did you see anything specific change there in that third period where you guys seem to have a little bit more intensity coming out there?
Yeah, I mean it's the battle we fight all year. Like we're a young team, and similar to 4 years ago when Connor and Keller Jones were freshmen, so we did the same thing that year. And it's every game's three games. First period, second period, third period, we're all over the map with our intensity and our compete, and I think you saw that tonight. The first period was poor, second period was good, and third and one time was excellent, and we were dominant. So we got to find a way to mature and figure out how to bottle this and come out with 60 minutes every night.
Any other questions?
Coach, just looked at tomorrow's game. What do you see needs to improve to take on Harvard and get that win?
I'll just read what I just said. Like we need to be better by 60. I think Harvard. If you look at the poll, which is a whole other story. I mean, they got 6 first place votes, which is a lot. And to be in 9th is just ridiculous. So there's obviously people somewhere, probably out west, that literally left them off the ballot, which I don't understand. They beat the number one team in the country last year. Last week they beat the number 4 team in the country. They've got 1 loss. I mean, they should be 1. I voted for them 1. They should be 1, 2, or 3. So anyway, the polls will sort themselves out. But I think Harvard's outstanding, and I think they're the best team in our league. And we'll have our hands full tomorrow. I need the boys to be ready to roll.
And what do they need to improve on the power play?
We have a great power play. We got great looks tonight. Landon, hits one off the post. We had a backdoor play. We had some good looks, and it just didn't go in. Gruber was good. You got to give him credit. He was good. Kartik was good. Both goalies were very good tonight. We always talk about not so much about power play, about scoring goals, but getting good looks. And I thought both units got good looks. Was it perfect? No. We could be a little bit better and have a little more intensity in the first one. But we got good looks.
Talk to the goal?
We were able to get in on the rush and create a little bit of chaos down low. Their D had no options, so he just rimmed it around the boards. And Bo Pieper had just changed, and he was able to get the puck to the net, and I just crashed and it happened to go off my foot and go through the goalie's legs and in.
They were blocking a lot of shots there for the first 2 periods. What adjustments did you guys make going into their end into overtime to get those pucks through?
I think the biggest thing for us was just keeping putting pucks at the net and not necessarily trying to make the perfect shot and pick a corner. It was just a matter of throwing pucks in his feet, creating rebounds, so we don't have to necessarily score a pretty goal, though Landon's shot was obviously unbelievable. We just wanted to get traffic and get bodies in the net and kind of have the chaos lead to an ugly goal.
Nate Owen, U.S. College Hockey, is there something you feel personally you've done this year to get yourself in the lineup more and see some more time on the ice?
I had a really good summer. I focused on working hard in the gym and making sure I had a compete mindset and really made sure that every day, rather than just kind of going through the motions, I actively tried to get better, and then just kind of tried to carry that attitude out onto the ice and take advantage of the summer that I had and go into corners and win battles and slowly over time earn my ice time so I get more and more responsibilities.
You guys simply got better as the game went on. Any explanation for the slow start and the progression as you got better and better?
For some reason, we've struggled a little bit with slow starts over the course of the season. We really just got to buckle down and get that energy up. We can't wait for them to get a lead for that to fire us up. Because although we've had some good opportunities here to come back from behind and win games, at some point it's going to bite us. We'll run into a hot goalie and we can't sweep 2 goals in the third or in OT to win the game. So we got to really emphasize coming out harder. As for what it is, I wish we knew, because then we'd change it real quick and then we'd be goals out of the first period. But I think it's just we got to come into the game ready to go right off the bat and not wait for something to get us going. We got to create our own motion.
Any other questions for Soren?
Yeah. This is your first Friday night win as a team since you guys defeated Union almost a month ago. How do you think that'll affect you guys going forward and trying to sweep the weekend tomorrow against Harvard?
I think it's always good to win Friday. I mean, even if it wasn't the prettiest first 2 periods we've ever played, Just the fact that we did get 2 points and it is a league game, we're able to build off that and we'll have confidence going in tomorrow. So hopefully we can take the energy and momentum that we created late in the game and carry that to the start of the game tomorrow so we don't have to wait as long. I mean, it's always good to win on Friday and everyone loves a sweep, so.